Thank you. Thank you. Why not movements 2, 3, and 4?
Thank you. Good morning. Please remain standing. With the marshal's placing of the university mace, we open the 2014 winter commencement exercises at the University of Nebraska, Kearney. On behalf of our graduates and students, the University of Nebraska Board of Regents, and our faculty, administration, and staff, I am pleased to welcome you. To begin our ceremonies, Kelsey Foote from North Platte will sing the national anthem. Kelsey is the daughter of Jeff and Deb Foote. She will graduate magna cum laude this morning from the College of Education with a major in elementary education. She has just returned to campus this week after completing her student teaching assignment in Houston. Pianist will be UNK staff collaborative pianist Nancy Curry. Kelsey. You may be seated. Thank you, Kelsey. Congratulations on your achievements and your graduation from UNK. At this time, I am honored to introduce Douglas Christensen, Ninth Chancellor of the University of Nebraska at Kearney. Chancellor Christensen.
Good morning. Welcome to the greatest day in the life of a university, commencement. Graduates, we're thrilled that you're here. Guests, welcome to these commencement ceremonies. Kelsey, thank you for your performance in the national anthem. We appreciate you sharing all of your talents with us. You know, today is a time to reflect on the past. For some of you, that past is a few short 4 years. For some of you, it's considerably longer. But it's also a day to look forward. And the word commencement denotes a fresh start. And that's really what today is all about. It's not an ending, but it's the beginning of the rest of your life, and we are so proud that you would share it with you, with us today. So as members of the graduating class, you're not concluding your education, but really beginning another phase of that. Along with your diploma, I hope you take with you the understanding that this is a lifelong talent to learn. You finished final exams, term papers, student teaching, internships. You've achieved all of your academic goals, and we want to acknowledge that this morning. You have every right to feel proud of yourself, and all of us here today share in that pride. And perhaps the most important thing is you've learned how to think, you've learned how to reason, you've followed your faculty's roles, you've followed their examples on how to pursue knowledge for the rest of your life. And I hope that as you begin your journey now from UNK, you'll always remember your time here, not simply as a group of life experiences, but as really a good reason to begin your future, that you've got a wonderful foundation, and that we hope that good fortune will follow you wherever you may go. So on behalf of the faculty, the staff, and the administration, thank you for choosing UNK. We're glad that you chose us as your institution. I'm confident that your university experience will pay tremendous dividends for the rest of your life. And we also hope that success will follow you every day. Thank you all for being here. Thank you.
Thank you, Chancellor. Now please welcome Tim Clare of Lincoln, member of the University of Nebraska Board of Regents. Regent Clare.
I just noticed these buttons. This is pretty neat. Well, good morning. My name is Tim Clare, and on behalf of my colleague Kent Schroeder and all of the Board of Regents for the University of Nebraska, we'd like to congratulate the graduates today and welcome you to this outstanding commencement exercise. You should be all very proud of what you accomplished here at the University of Nebraska-Kearney. Because of your hard work, you are now in an excellent position to begin successful careers, improve the quality of your life and the life of your families, and give back to the communities in which you will live and work. I commend each of you for making the very wise decision to pursue higher education. I'm confident that this decision will pay off for you for the rest of your lives, no matter which direction you would choose. Since I'm the very proud parent of college students myself, we actually have four children in undergraduate at UNL and one child in graduate school at UNL, and I know tuition, and I've also informed the officials at the university that we don't have any more children at home, so they're not going to see any more enrollment increases because of our family. I'd be remiss, though, if I didn't also recognize the family members and others who have helped these graduates along the way. Your support, guidance, and encouragement is tremendously valuable in shaping these young lives. Without supportive family members and friends, caring faculty, and other mentors, some of these students would not be sitting where they are today. So thank you for all that you have done. The University of Nebraska-Kearney is a wonderful institution within the University of Nebraska system, and I don't just say that. I know that the Board of Regents is very pleased with this campus's contributions to the state of Nebraska and to communities around the world. In the 6 short years that I have served on the board, the progress that this campus has made is truly incredible. And again, we're very proud of the role that that UNK plays within the state and within the university system. And my hope is that each of you leaves here today feeling well prepared for whatever challenges await you next. Some of you are about to begin careers. Some of you may not be finished with school yet and may be pursuing graduate school. Some of you may work for a family enterprise or start your own business someday. Some of you will raise families, or travel, or come up with some innovative idea that revitalizes your community or the world. These and countless other opportunities are available to you because, in the words of UNL alum Warren Buffett, you invested in yourself, you worked hard, and you earned a college degree. I am confident that you will look back and reaffirm that the University of Nebraska-Kearney was the right choice for you, and I congratulate you and wish you the very best in your future endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you, Regent Clare. It's always a pleasure to have you with us. I would also like to acknowledge other special guests and members of our platform party who will not be introduced later in the ceremony. I ask that they stand as I call their names. Please hold your applause until all have been introduced. To my right is former Nebraska State Senator Jim Cuddeback, and on the platform, University of Nebraska Regent Kent Schroeder, Student Body President and Student Regent Connor Schulte, Vice Chancellor for Business and Finance Barbara Johnson, Director of Athletics, Paul Plinsky, and Interim Dean for the Division of Student Affairs, Joseph Hinga. Each commencement, the university's faculty and administration are invited to nominate students from among the graduates to deliver a brief address. Today's speaker is Jared Pettit of Kearney. This morning, he will graduate from the College of Business and Technology with a major in construction management. Jared is a student whose degree path has been quite different from that of most, probably all, of his classmates. For 15 years, Jared has been a staff sergeant and certified combat lifesaver for the Nebraska Army National Guard, and he has been a member of the National Guard Honor Guard for 4 years. He served our country as a team leader in Al-Takaitim, Iraq, from 2006 to 2007. He has also served the community as both a firefighter and a lieutenant in the Kearney Volunteer Fire Department, and is a nationally certified emergency medical responder. Included in his employment history is his work as a refrigerator control technician in UNK's Division of Facilities from 2003 till 2005. As a UNK student these past several years, Jared has proven himself an outstanding leader both in and out of the classroom. He is a member of the Epsilon Pi Tau Honor Society and is founder and president of UNK's American Concrete Institute student chapter. In 2013, he was named the American Concrete Institute Outstanding Student, a first ever for UNK. Historically, this honor has been presented to a student at UNL's College of Engineering. Overall, he exemplifies leadership and integrity in the classroom, in the community, and as a member of our armed forces. Please welcome Jared Pettit to speak on behalf of the graduating class of 2014.
Thank you. I wanted to mess with that button just simply because I could, so that's a pretty rad little thing there. Members of the Board of Regents, Chancellor Christensen, faculty, distinguished guests, family, friends, and more importantly, graduates. It is with the utmost respect and gratitude that I stand before you today. As Laudato Equiano states in his interesting narrative from 1789, I offer here the history of neither a saint, a hero, nor a tyrant. While we may not share in the same history or beliefs, Equiano has taught me that every individual's experiences need to be cherished for what they can teach us and how they give shape and meaning to every one of our lives. Today, I speak of sacrifice, I speak of my faith, and I speak of my life as an American soldier. As I began to sift through the emotions, memories, and lessons learned here at UNK, I reflected on our journey that is culminating in this very celebration. Each and every one of us has no doubt strode a unique path to arrive here today. I cannot tell you my entire story, but I will share with you a few things that have sustained me to this point. Before I begin, I'd like to begin with the emotion of fear. A fear that if in the middle of accounting class, you received a message from the chancellor's office simply stating, we need to speak with you as soon as possible regarding graduation. Immediately, I thought to myself, have they really gotten this serious about parking tickets? Thankfully, that was not the case. Rather shortly thereafter, I was informed of the great news of speaking today. And as if on cue, the people and events that have influenced me began to flood my thoughts. I thought of myself as an 8-year-old boy sitting on my family's front porch in Bingham, Nebraska, watching my mother leave for yet another day of nursing school. I distinctly remember how very long her days were and how her just getting out the door while taking care of each and one of her 5 children was a victory in itself. Then and there, my mother forever instilled in me the importance of an education and the high price that one must be willing to pay in order to achieve it. I pondered my days in the military, where I learned how to turn me into we, and the amazing things that a team of well-disciplined individuals could accomplish, as well as the very tough trials that very same team could endure. My mind took me to a place where I heard the sounds of artillery and gunfire in the distance, and I immediately thought sadly for our soldiers and Marines, sailors and airmen, who have fallen in battle in defense of something greater than themselves. I thought hard for our Gold Star families who daily bear the weight of losing a loved one far too soon. I looked through a frosty window and I saw the snap of our flag in a cold, brisk wind, and I became very proud and very thankful. However, this gratitude and pride was cloaked with a very heavy coat of loss and of defeat. In an instant, I felt the suffocating pain of a moment inside a small chapel not far from the city of Fallujah, Iraq. The moment that our convoy security company was notified that one of our very own had been killed in action. Sergeant Randy Matheny was that soldier's name, and his sacrifice, as well as the inspiring story of a wounded warrior by the name of Dennis Cabanning, kept my perspective forever grounded in the moment and constantly reminded me that our tomorrows are not promised. The significance of this event, as well as all of our achievements, caused me to reach for every source of strength and courage that I could. I prayed my Lord's Prayer, and I recall so vividly a small church in Hyannis, Nebraska, a small church where my father taught me as a young man how to humbly ask for help and how to give thanks to those who gave it. For a moment, I was at peace, and for once in my life, I was able to recognize my struggles and my sufferings in the very same arena as my victories and celebrations. I looked for the proper methods to describe and convey this to each and every soul that shared in it. This included the American taxpayer, our men and women in uniform, numerous professors, instructors, staff, and my entire family. My wife, Bobby Ann, and our children, Emmy and Jackson, for example, daily went without so that we could achieve what seemed at times as an unreachable goal. To me, this was proof that faith, hope, and love can and will endure all things. Lastly, I thought of the many faculty and staff that would be just as honored as I was to celebrate in this honor with me. Each one of them raced through my mind, leaving their very own unique mark. Everything from the patience that I learned from a Dr. Nathan Berry to the selfless service that Kathy Benny and Jamie Kester daily show our industrial technology students. I also look forward to sharing this news with a very certain professor, a very knowledgeable and very compassionate and a very German-American, Dr. Kennard Larson. I thank you from the bottom of my heart, sir. I will carry all the lessons that you have taught me for a lifetime. This university certainly owes you and your wife, Dixie, a debt of gratitude, and we wish you nothing but the very best of luck in your retirement. Your leadership and caring spirit will be missed here on campus. Sir Danke für alles, Wiedersehen, mein Freund. German for, thank you for everything. So long, my friend. As we leave this building and go about celebrating this great accomplishment, I would encourage each and every one of you to spend a moment reflecting yourselves. Identify those people, those moments, and those events that have impacted your life. Reach out to those who you can, and remember, there has always been a we behind the me. I leave you with these words of Theodore Roosevelt written in 1910. The wisdom within these words I have heard and read many times. However, they did not ring true to my ears until I stepped foot on the battlefield myself as a soldier. One of the brightest men I have ever come to know in life, who lost his life far too soon, left them to me as I departed my homeland for war. A very young, promising medical student by the name of Jonathan James Jacobson. It is not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust, sweat, and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcoming. But who does actually strive to do the deeds, who knows the great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who, at the best, in the end, knows the triumph of high achievement, but who, at the worst, if he fails, at least he fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who know neither victory nor defeat. These words have sustained me through some of the most trying times, and I very simply would not be here in front of you today if I did not cherish these words and if they did not live for me each and every day. While I certainly do not expect these words to inspire you as they have me, I do know that our education here at UNK, both in and outside of the classroom, can help us appreciate and help us make meaning of this often confusing world. It is my hope for all of you that you have found that. Today, my friends, we all share in a victory. Congratulations and Godspeed to you all.
Jared, thank you most sincerely for your service and congratulations on your graduation from UNK. The Corleers is a select mixed voice chorus that is open to all university students through competitive audition. Throughout the years, they have performed across Nebraska and at both national and international venues. Earlier today, they provided the pre-commencement concert, and at this time, we welcome their special performance of Because We Believe by Andrea Bocelli. A portion of their performance will be sung in Italian and will feature a bass trio of UNK students, Thomas Johnson, Jacob Knudsen, and Nolan Pribno. Dr. Bauer.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Bauer, and thank you, students. Chancellor Christensen.
Thank you, Corleers. Thank you, Professor Bauer. Your performances are always outstanding, and today was no exception. Jared Dell, wow. Thank you. It's wonderful. It's been an honor to have you as a UNK student. We hope that you never forget your institution. I doubt that you will. Regents Claire, Regent Schroeder, and Regent Schulte, thank you for being here today with us as well. It's my pleasure this morning to introduce our keynote speaker, Dr. Tyler Martin. We are quite proud to call Dr. Martin one of our own. A native Nebraskan, a 1981 graduate of this institution, and a 1986 graduate of the University of Nebraska College of Medicine, he began his career in Norfolk, Nebraska, where he was a clinical infectious disease physician, and where, supported with revenue from his practice, he established a molecular biology lab to further study vaccine-resistant malaria, his research interest as a postdoctoral fellow. Since then, a remarkably keen mind and an avid interest in pharmaceuticals has led him on a professional journey that is, at best, very difficult to condense into a short period of time for today's brief introduction. It has included extensive therapeutic research, development, and collaboration with institutions such as Chiron, Park Davis, Novartis, Valentis, Dynavax Technologies, to name a few. His body of work has impacted vaccine development and therapeutic advances in the areas such as HIV, gene and stem cell technologies, oncology, hematology, immunology, cardiovascular disease, pain, and neurology. He has and continues to literally travel the world with responsibilities that include an ongoing oversight of conduct and integration regarding the development of clinical and medical functions as they relate to infectious diseases and to exploratory development. Dr. Martin and his wife, Mary Kay, have recently relocated from California back to Nebraska. Hooray. He's currently the founder and CEO of Great Plains Biotechnology in Lincoln, an enterprise which provides advice and support to companies developing new life science products and diligent review to investigators looking to advance life science companies. He also serves as CEO and Director of Technologies of New York, a privately owned biopharmaceutical company representing world-leading experience in therapeutic vaccines. Suffice it to say, his contributions to medical research across lines and be far beyond any borders. It is our honor, Tyler, to welcome you back to your alma mater, Dr. Tyler Martin.
Thank you, Chancellor Christensen. Another way to describe all those different companies I've been a part of is I can't keep a job, but thank you for the kind introduction. Good morning, faculty, administration, staff, regents. Good morning, families and friends of the graduates. And good morning to you graduates. Congratulations. Today is a day of celebration. We celebrate you. We celebrate your completion of years of study, of mastering an academic discipline that has resulted in your recognition today as a graduate of the University of Nebraska at Kearney. It's a special day for you and for those who care for you. This is indeed a day to celebrate. UNK has had a profound influence on my life. My mother received her education credentials here in the late 1950s. My father received his bachelor's degree here in 1959. My uncle received his bachelor's degree here in the 1960s. I met my wife here. I graduated from here in 1981. My brother graduated from here in 1984. UNK has had a profound influence on myself and my family. As Chancellor Christensen said, when I graduated from here with a major in chemistry and a minor in biology, I went to the University of Nebraska Medical Center, where I graduated with my medical degree. I subsequently completed a
residency in pediatrics at the University of Nebraska Medical Center. I then completed a postdoctoral fellowship in infectious diseases and molecular microbiology at Washington University in St. Louis. Came back to Nebraska for a few years to practice clinical medicine, and then went off to join the biotech world with my mentor from WashU. So we've been in San Francisco for 20 years and recently have returned. I've had the privilege of building and leading teams that have developed vaccines and drugs that have had an impact on human health. We developed an innovative influenza vaccine that's currently approved for commercial use in Europe, an antibiotic that's approved globally, and an inhaled antibiotic called Tobi that transformed the lives of children with cystic fibrosis. It's been my pleasure to work with those groups. 18 months ago, we came back and have started Great Plains Biotechnology in Lincoln. It's my desire to create a life science biotechnology community here. There are substantial advantages to doing business in Nebraska, one of which is the quality of the people that live in this state, and that's what I want to talk to you about a little bit more today. In July, I accepted the position as CEO of Adjuvants Technologies, a vaccine company that spun out of Memorial Sloan Kettering Hospital in New York, and we're in the process of moving the company from Manhattan, New York, to Lincoln as the first step on this road to collecting and building biotechnology companies here. My experience at UNK prepared me for a life of adventure. When I graduated from UNK, I did not know the job I do today existed. I was planning to go to medical school, become a primary care physician, and go back to live and serve in a small town like the one I grew up in, Hebron, Nebraska. I learned some things during that time, and I want to share with you today three principles that I found to be useful to me and I hope will be useful to you. Those three principles are: be grateful, be humble, and be faithful. Over the years, I've come to realize that I don't accomplish things by myself. There are, and there have been, many persons and events that shaped my life and shaped my circumstances such that I've had opportunities. Yes, I had to take advantage of those opportunities myself, but it would be extremely short-sighted to not acknowledge and be grateful for the persons and events who created the possibilities to experience those opportunities. As an example, here we have taxpayers and donors who provide the resources necessary to support the mission at UNK. They aren't people that you see every day, but there are people that without their contribution, what you've accomplished would not be possible. We have the faculty and the administration, those that you love and have developed deep affection for during your years here, and those that you haven't. They carry out this mission. You have friends who've stood by you and family who've loved and helped you as best they could. And all of the successes and all of the failures in your life have shaped you to be the person who you are today, the person that the rest of us celebrate today. Today, we're proud of you and we celebrate you. Tomorrow, don't forget to be grateful for the people and events that have created this opportunity for you. You've learned much about the world and your area of study during your years at UNK. You've developed insights and strengths on this journey. Be confident in these newly developed attributes. Celebrate them today. Tomorrow, be considerate of your limitations, ignorance, and weaknesses. Shakespeare wrote, "The fool doth think he is wise, but the wise man knows himself to be a fool." Our knowledge is limited in breadth and in depth. Postmodern literary theory teaches us to be humble with our limited perspective and to acknowledge that our cultural location limits our ability to know all things. And experience shows that we tend to seek our own interests at the expense of others, perhaps in elegant ways, but bent selfward nonetheless. I learned that it's important to embrace these parts of ourselves, not to revel in darkness or folly, but to strengthen our weaknesses, to become more whole, and to develop kinship with others who may not have the same weaknesses that we do, but have their own areas of weakness, struggle, or challenge. Each of you has areas of strength that today we celebrate. Tomorrow, consider your areas of weakness and set out to know yourself and to be humble. Today we celebrate your faithfulness in your area of study, which has led to your graduation. We celebrate that. But I've learned that true faithfulness demands more. It demands that we apply our study, indeed our whole person, to living in a manner that is faithful to our God, ourselves, our community, and our world. As graduates, you will receive privileges that others do not, and you'll be expected to make contributions that are not expected from others. Look for opportunities to practice faithfulness and generosity. Diligently search for opportunities to give more to your community. From a global perspective, you are a one percenter. How can you empower and enable the 99? Each of you will have different opportunities to exercise faithfulness. Harvest these opportunities that come to you by serving as you're able. Celebrate your faithfulness today, extend it tomorrow. In closing, today you celebrate an ending, a conclusion of this period of your academic life in preparation for your next season of life. It is indeed a day to celebrate. Celebrate it with family, friends, and faculty who walked beside you and are proud of what you have accomplished. Celebrate. Tomorrow, just around the corner, is the beginning of a new season full of adventure mixed with hope and dread. As you turn that corner, be grateful for those that gave to you. Be honest with yourself, humbly recognizing your strengths and limitations, and seek to contribute your bests to others, creating opportunities for them to grow, for them to be grateful, and for them to serve. I look forward to days in the future when we will hear how you were transformed and how you transformed the communities you enter in your next season of life. Now today we celebrate you, the 2014 graduates of the University of Nebraska at Kearney. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Martin. I join Chancellor Christensen and the UNK faculty in congratulating you and welcoming you home. I would also like to acknowledge your family members who are here today. Your wife, Mary Kay, your parents, Jerry and Sandy Martin. Jerry is also a UNK alumnus. Would you please stand so we can recognize you? Thank you again. The Leland Holt Security Mutual Life Distinguished Faculty Award is presented each year at winter commencement. The award honors Mr. Leland Holt, an alumnus of our institution, and it commemorates his many years of leadership at Security Mutual Life. The award fund was created by Mr. Holt and Security Mutual Life and provides a stipend of $5,000 to a UNK faculty member who has demonstrated excellence in teaching, research, and service. Presenting the 2014 Leland Holt Award this morning will be Chancellor Christensen.
The strength of a university and its relevance has one element, and that's its faculty. It's our honor this morning to recognize one of those faculty members. Today's recipient of the Leland Holt Security Mutual Life Distinguished Faculty Award joined the faculty in 1999. And it is said of her that she hit the floor running, first regarding her excellence in teaching. This recipient has previously been awarded UNK's Pratt Hines Award for Teaching, an award presented only to the most outstanding educators, regardless of their field. Her teaching evaluation summary scores are consistently top level and are routinely accompanied by comments regarding her knowledge of the subject and her caring disposition. Many past students credit her for significant impacts in their lives, both college and post-college careers. She is a highly sought-after research mentor, and international students seek her out because of her reputation for being patient, caring, and fun. In addition to the classroom, she has been instrumental in revising her department's undergraduate and graduate program curriculums and has created several courses in her area of expertise. In the area of research, her involvement with the Institutional Development Awards Network of Biomedical Research Excellence stands out in particular. She is described as a pioneer of this program, and since its beginning, has resulted in over $3.3 million of funding coming to UNK to assist in the training of undergraduates in biomedical research. Just as impressive may be the number of students she works with and the number of grants and presentation awards that her students have earned. Lastly, this recipient is said to be the go-to person for any task her department wants to undertake. Service is part of who she really is. She has been on other departments' hiring committees and academic program reviews, on university-wide committees, and many, many other committees that needed her. Her colleagues say she never says no and never fails to maintain the highest standards in the classroom and in the lab. Professor Julie Schaefer, it gives me great pleasure to announce that you are the 2014 recipient of the Leland Holt Security Mutual Distinguished Faculty Award. Would you please come forward? Julie, thank you for all you have done on the benefit of your students, and on behalf of this institution, we all are very appreciative. Congratulations.
And on behalf of your colleagues and many friends, please accept our warmest congratulations. Now we have arrived at that special moment, the conferring of degrees. We will begin with the awarding of the graduate degrees. Candidates will be presented by Dr. Kenya Taylor, Associate Vice Chancellor for Academic Affairs and Dean of Graduate Studies and Research.
Will the candidates for graduate degrees please rise? Chancellor Christensen, these applicants have fulfilled all the requirements established by the Board of Regents for their respective graduate degrees. Therefore, the graduate faculty recommends that these candidates be granted the graduate degree along with the privileges and responsibilities that accompany the degree.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of the University of Nebraska, and upon the recommendation of the faculty of the University of Nebraska at Kearney, I hereby confer upon each of you the appropriate graduate degree and admit you to all of its rights, privileges, obligations. Congratulations.
Candidates, you may be seated. Associate Dean of Graduate Studies and Research, Catherine Zuckweiler, will read the names of the graduates. Hooding the candidates for graduate degrees are Assistant Professor of Family Studies and Interior Design, Tony Hill, Professor of Kinesiology and Sports Sciences, Gregory Brown, Department Chair and Professor of Music and Performing Arts, Timothy Farrell, and Professor of Biology, Julie Schaefer.
The Graduate College is pleased to recognize the achievements of these graduates. Earning the Master of Science in Education degree, Brett Ashley Enns. Earning the Education Specialist degree, David J. Mrachek. Mandy Joanne Plogue. Earning the Master of Arts degree, Lynette Cheryl Calkins. Jacob Allen Eberlein. Cole Thomas Kruger. Matthew D. Norton. Earning the Master of Arts in Education degree, Carissa Lynn Eberhardt. Valerie Mae Ellis. Kate M. Hannon. Tyler Herman. Brett Ray Larson. Gina R. McKay. J.C. K. Palmer. Catherine Shepler. Michelle Lynn Young. Jesse L. Zavadl. Earning the Master of Science degree, Dustin Paul Franklin. Jonathan Ian Newkirk. Earning the Master of Science in Education degree, Catherine Renee Bertrand. Jennifer Ray Carlson. Lindsay C. Kluel. Nicole Janae King. Christian Roland Lee Cruz. Elizabeth K. Lewis. Jordan M. Purdy. Bobby Jean Ridenour. Elizabeth A. Roberts. Srividya Samir. Lindsay A. Shoemaker. Caitlin M. Wilson. Sarah Yendra. Earning the Master of Business Administration degree, Kelsey J. Sharp.
Chancellor Christensen. These are our recipients of graduate degrees. Will you please join me in congratulating them?
At this time, we will confer the undergraduate degrees. Senior Vice Chancellor for Academic and Student Affairs, Charles Bisek, will present the candidates for the baccalaureate degrees.
Will the candidates for the baccalaureate degrees please rise? Chancellor Christensen, I am happy to present to you to the candidates for the baccalaureate degrees in their specialized areas. They have completed all the requirements for the degrees as prescribed by the University of Nebraska at Kearney and the Board of Regents. It is the recommendation of the faculty that they be granted their degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of the University of Nebraska, and upon the recommendation of your faculty, I hereby confer upon each of you the baccalaureate degree and admit you to the Fellowship of Educated Women and Men with all of its rights, honors, privileges, and obligations. Congratulations.
Baccalaureate candidates, you may be seated. The undergraduate degrees will be presented by the deans of the academic colleges: Tim Berkink, Business and Technology; Ed Scantling, Education; Bill Germa, Fine Arts and Humanities; and John LeDuc, Natural and Social Sciences. Reading the names of the graduates will be Associate Dean Susan Jensen, College of Business and Technology; Associate Dean Dennis Potthoff, College of Education; Associate Dean Darren Snyder, College of Fine Arts and Humanities; and Associate Professor of Political Science Claude Louisome, College of Natural and Social Sciences.
The College of Business and Technology are very proud to present our graduates receiving the baccalaureate degree. Receiving the Bachelor of Science, Caitlin Renee Bove. Receiving the Bachelor of Arts, Jansu Artukush. Receiving the Bachelor of Science, Alyssa Albrecht. Sean Christopher Arkell. Margaret J. Arlt. Cody R. Beeson. Aaron N. Bebout. Lisa Lynn A. Bergman. Jacob Ronald Betson. Ryan Bristol. G. Chow. Felicia M. Charter. Drew Daniel Simino. Corey James Cruzan. Ethan James Donnell. Yao Yao Dung. Brett N. Douglas. Christopher F. Feldman. Shua Fung. Chance Trey Friedley. Shunpai Fujita. Cheyenne S. Falk. Kristen M. Gilmeen. Paige M. Glasshoff. Esben Giovanni Gomez Crispin. Claire Griffin. Joshua Michael Hankins. Cody James Hanneman. Kimberly Marie Harper. Bryson W. Hinkle. Martha Maria Herarte. Johanna Joyce Holm. Jordan Casey Eiley Robinson. Jingting Jia. Aisha D. Johnson. Lars Karstens. Kimberly Kearns. Matthew Robert Klein. Miranda Lynn Cluthy. Carly Jean Kerner. Masami Kokubu. Austin A. Land. Jacob Ethan Langley. Derek C. League. Nicholas W. Lee. Philip Y. Lee. Samantha K. Lee. Zachary Richard Legano. Pagia Lee. Yuhan Liu. Jing Liu. Melinda Lush. Nilima Maharjan. Ross Carl Martin. Alexander B. McNay. Kyle David Michaelis. Former student body president and student regent, Moses D. Moxie. Gabriella Monserrate Myers. Sarah A. Oberg. Tracy Marie Oberhauser. Scott Mitchell Pfeffer. Masaya Sakaguchi. Kelby Jean Seil. Rose Margaret Smith. Stephanie J. Sotelo. Austin Tybemol. Ryosuke Take. Wei-Chin Wong. Jack Riley Wardine. Stephanie Lynn Wagner. Shawning Wei. Cassie Marie Wells. Jake Wheeler. Austin E. White. Rachel Wild. Michaela Nicole Young. Gangjuan Zhang. Mingting Zhang. Jared Lee Pettit.
College of Education is very proud of the following individuals who've earned baccalaureate degrees. McKenna Joe Tenbensel. Ashley N. K. Agason. Alyssa Arnold. Martha Lorena Arroyo. Kristen Ball. Bryn Barnes. Matthew John Berry. Kinsey Lynn Butler. Amelia Ann Beeler. Alyssa Louise Bruce. Nicole Brummels. Derek Stephen Camp. Austin Joe Carmichael. Kayla Lynn Cass. Courtney Cave. Roxana M. Chamul. Tanner David Collins. Hello. Heather Nicole Connolly. Hannah DeWitt. Austin Faith Dole. Rebecca Ann Dunn. Kelsey Nicole Foote. Amelia E. Gock. Sarah Elizabeth Hild. Kelsey A. Eisen. Shannon Beth Jarvie. Danielle Jo Callison. Catherine Elizabeth Klinetsky. Desiree Komescher. Kelsey Korth. Tad Lewis Kruger. Carson Kuntz. Kaylee Lee. Tiffany Ray Laffelholz. Rebecca A. Miller. Ashley Nicole Moody. Selena C. Mortimer. Caitlin Carey Olson. Mitchell Carl Olson. Cecily N. Panter. Paige Marie Fingston. Seth M. Schaefer. Abby Michelle Shuck. Kelly Shuck. Janessa Slattery. Jordan Yvonne Smith. Brittany E. Stevens. Jacob J. Stutzman. Tersa Swedberg. Brooke Marie Teal. Alexis Tile. Jamie Lynn Tureen. Alicia Dawn Weaver. Ashley Rose Weber. Brittany May Blaylock. Davis S. Brindle. Emily K. Charles. Alyssa Marie Conrad. I. Hidani. Trey A. Johnson. Benjamin A. Kugler. Jordan David Marquardt. Ellie Renee Reedy. Michael Falcon. Gabrielle Elizabeth Tucker. Sierra Nicole Welsh. Amanda Marie Wusk. Adrian A. Hobbled, Bethany Ann Hickman, Jillian Marie Hickman, Casey J. Higgins, Bailey R. Hoover.
The faculty of the College of Fine Arts and Humanities is proud to congratulate the following candidates for the bachelor's degree. Travis Robert Stewart, Danielle Nicole Bartels, Hannah Lee Bloom, Maria Teresita Magana, Michael H. Mia, Elizabeth M. Munoz, Allison Marie Schaefer, Azucena Vera Chavez, Patience Elizabeth Buck, Casey J. Conley, Kayla Beth Essink, Hillary J. Fink, Diego D. Gamero Gutierrez, Kenzie Lee Helmick, Trinity Lynn Kennedy, Virgil Patrick Nelson, Haley Dawn Preby, Alexandra L. Stollecker, Matthew Joseph Stubbs, Joshua James Crawford, Stephen John Fankhauser, Rio Moriwaki, Brooke E. Poppy, Utah Tsugino, Alyssa Renee Brady, Shawnee S. Gaspari, Raisa Julianne Gates, Matt J. Schultz, Victoria Jane Thompson, Jennifer Nicole McMurtry, and Riley B. Folkmer.
Good morning. On behalf of the College of Natural and Social Sciences, I'm proud to announce and introduce the students earning their bachelor's degree. Caitlin May Mimic, Philip Martin Angle, Caitlin Marie Lawrence, Dalia N. Ruvalcaba, Angelica Maria Villabona Carrero, Lane Hoskins, Stephanie Cecilia Lyons, Joshua Paul Redman, Kevin R. Snyder, Brittany Adams, Alicia Allen, Travis J. Anderson, Monica Daniela Arroyo, Brian Donald Bird, Matthew P. Bry, Julie Ann Burbach, Catherine Denny Davieu, Kristen Lynn Drahota, Cole Pinsky, Kimberly Marie Fonseca, Shannon M. Fox, Josie Gitchwin, Megan Elizabeth Hooper, Cruz Cecilia Hurtado, Wade Jensen, Jesse Lee Johnson, Jacob D. Kaufman, Taylor Ray Knuth, Victoria Marie Kremlesek, I'm sorry, Shay Leggett, Heather Ray Lindberg, Cole Ryder Manhart, Jacob M. Meyer, Mohammed Abdallah Mohammed, Andrew Thomas Poinsett, Kaylee Nicole Prater, Holiday Lyle Quezada, Nicholas Ridgway, Aracela Santos, Morgan Danielle Schulte, Jordan Lynn Schultz, Kaylee Dawn Schultz, Aspen Shirley, Kelsey Lynn Shrum, Cassandra Joy Smith, Jordan Lee Spear, Tyler Scott Stickley, Matthew Tyler Tenorio, Devon Michael Thorne, Jade Lee Elizabeth Vavarek, Megan Christine Wolf, Jeffrey B. Britteman, Sierra J. Higgins, Thomas Ostick, Brianne Schneider, Patrick Dylan Schrott, Danielle Nicole Thornton, Kyle Greg Perrette, Elizabeth Jacqueline Stevenson, Lindsay Jean Lozier,
Chancellor Christensen, these are the baccalaureate graduates. Will all of you please join me in extending our congratulations to them?
Congratulations, graduates. Chancellor Christensen.
Do you know how impressive it is to watch each one of these graduates get their degree and have all of you stay here? I'm serious. That is so impressive. Thank you for doing that. It means a lot to the graduates as well. And I think it also symbolizes that this is a family institution where we're proud of everybody, and we appreciate you being patient with us this morning. We're going to get out of here on time, but there's a few things we need to do yet. First of all, I'm going to ask that everyone who is a UNK graduate, for those of you, if you're a Kearney State graduate, you can stand too. Would you all please stand for just a moment? Graduates, alumni. Okay, now just a second. We're going to have you help us here a second. Now, please stay standing. We'd like you to help us with the turning of the tassel. The turning of the tassel after candidates have received their diploma is a time-honored tradition. It symbolizes the transition from candidate to graduate and from student to alumni. It's a well-earned privilege. Graduates, now is the appropriate time to stand with your fellow alumni and turn your tassels. Please do so. You may be seated. Thank you. There's another important tradition, and that's to recognize our distinguished faculty, from our newest serving to our longest serving, and everyone in between. Our faculty is second to none. We're extremely proud of them. Would our faculty and emeriti faculty, would you please stand and be recognized this morning? Thank you. There are scores of people who are staff members, some who are here, some who are at other events right now, who have helped to make this morning's ceremony such a success. And I just want to make sure that you all know, staff people, who you are. We couldn't do it without you. Thank you very much. All right, graduates, that diploma you have in your hand, it doesn't guarantee you success, but it does guarantee you that you've had the best preparation possible. And the citizens of the state of Nebraska have put a lot of resources in to make sure that that degree is valuable and meaningful. And that degree has a little bit of responsibility, and I think we all owe our best efforts and our best expectations for the common good. And so we hope that you share those skills generously with others. We hope that you engage whatever community you decide to live in and make a positive difference. And we also hope that you do things that are important and that don't just make yourself important. With you as graduates, our future is so bright here at the University of Nebraska at Kearney. I hope that good fortune always finds you. And thank you to each and every one of you who participated this morning.
Thank you, Chancellor. And now, as the commencement ceremony concludes, I ask the audience to please remain seated until the recessional has been completed. University Marshal Garrison Gonfaloniers, would you please prepare for the recessional? Will the stage party and university faculty please stand? Mr. Schulwin, University Marshal, please begin the recessional.